Over 10 years ago, only about 80 hectares of organic peas and fava beans were cultivated in Switzerland. This accounted for only 3% of Swiss demand for organic feed. The risk for farmers was high and the prices were rather low compared to wheat. Therefore, large quantities of organic feed were imported, especially organic soy from China. BioSuisse increasingly had a credibility problem because of these imports. In this video, I will explain how we addressed this problem. BioSuisse and FiBL set up a protein working group in 2008. The aim was to gradually increase self-sufficiency in feed and reduce the import of soya from China. In addition to agricultural advisors and producers, the working group included two feed mills, Rytz and Lehmann. On the one hand, the problems of growing protein crops had to be solved. At the same time, sales had to be secured and the financial side needed to be more attractive. The following problem existed for grain legume cultivation. Peas grown in pure stands often started lodging before they were harvested. Before converting to organic, we grew peas in pure stands. They were growing wonderfully until 14 days before threshing. Then it got a bit windy and the peas were flat on the ground. Then the threshing became tedious. Many weeds grew through the crop despite the use of herbicides. Now we mix it with barley, which is a very good crop and cultivation technique for us. In intercropping, the barley supports the pea crop and the mixture can be harvested with fewer losses. The cultivation of legumes as an intercrop is interesting for us because we don't have livestock on a farm and therefore have to buy fertilizer. However, we do not have to fertilize the legumes, and they are also an interesting crop in terms of yield value. There are several reasons for using peas, barley. One is the production of protein domestically. There is a great shortage of protein in Switzerland. We have to import a lot of it from far away. Also to the detriment of the exporting countries. I think it is a shame not to produce a raw material in Switzerland we could actually produce.
Une matière première que l'on a possibilité de produire.
The idea of growing intercrops for grain legumes came from France, via the French-speaking part of Switzerland to the German-speaking region. Maurice Clerc, my retired colleague, started the first trials in French-speaking Switzerland.
Nos grands-parents cultivaient déjà.
Our grandparents were already practicing intercropping. And even then, two mixtures worked very well. Protein peas and barley on the one hand, and field beans oats on the other. We started with these mixtures again in order to adapt them to the current situation. Intercropping legumes and cereals was also well known in our region, but they used to make silage with it and harvested the mixture before the grains, kernels or the cereal were fully mature. Together with the farmers, we conducted trials to further develop suitable mixtures, mixing ratios, sowing and harvesting techniques, and the maintenance measures. In organic feed, we highly value grain legumes, both peas and field beans. In pig feed, we have a pea content of over 30%. And peas and field beans are also very suitable for cattle feed. The commitment of the two mills, Rytz and Lehmann, was central. They developed a process for separating the different grain and grain legumes. They also guaranteed sales.
Außerdem haben sie uns den Absatz garantiert.
A farmer who would like to start growing grain can contact us. Barley, peas are always in demand. In the field bean stroke oat mixture, the hectoliter weight of oat is sometimes too low. Then we have to clean the mixture more thoroughly.
Und das je nach Qualität, dass man den halt muss rausputzen.
Bei der Preisgestaltung spielte die Fava.
BIO Suisse's group of experts on arable crops also played an important role in the pricing. The target price was increased by 10 francs per deciton. BIO Suisse siphoned off this subsidy from imported grain and transferred it to grain legumes.
Ab und lagerte ihn auf die Körnerleguminosen um. Ein weiterer Erfolgsfaktor war.
A further success factor was that as a result of our lobbying, the federal government adapted a direct payment ordinance, so that intercrops now also received a full grain legume contribution, provided that they contain at least 30% grain legumes.
Enthalten mindestens 30% Körnerleguminosen.
En plus de cela, certains cantons.
In addition, some cantons provide cantonal subsidies. This is because intercrops are an important contribution to resource efficiency, and their flowers and diversity also contribute to the beauty of the landscape.
Par leurs fleurs et par la diversité qu'elles amènent.
Das alles hat sich sehr positiv auf die Entwicklung.
All this had a very positive effect on the development of intercrops. Today, approximately 1,000 hectares of peas and field beans are cultivated in Switzerland. The degree of protein self-sufficiency has increased from 3 to 15%.
Auf 15% angewachsen.
The decisive factor was that the entire value chain, including the association and politicians, was represented in this working group. The example shows that it is not enough to improve cultivation techniques alone. The framework conditions must be designed so that producer prices are fair and sales are guaranteed.